Jordan?
Yeah.
The first thing I like to do is I like to put this elbow, sorry, this knee in the hole. Now if you notice, I put it in the hole and I don't have it wedged against his side. If you wedge it against his side, as soon as he moves, I have no longer have an option of moving this foot. Like I can move it out and give up position, but I can't really improve my position when it's wedged. So I push it past. Now, why I do this is because it creates a smaller circle for me to move my foot. I only have to rotate around his arm versus when I'm trying to step over, I have to rotate around his arm and his leg to try to get to the, where I need to be. So I cut down a shorter circle by just doing this. I keep this foot out. This is the only thing I'm taking right now. Now, when I get where I feel comfortable, I extend my leg back out and I come back down. If you notice, my hips are a lot closer to my knee than it was when I was reaching my foot. And I come straight up. Now that's the goal. Honestly, it doesn't always happen. Sometimes the guy, he thinks he's onto something. So he tries to circle towards this way, tries to step over. Now, in practice, this is going to go one two ways. It's either going to be feet that you can hook or feet that you can't. If he circles to the point where his hips aren't at an angle steep enough that I can't hook this, I'm going to do this. So as long as I can do this, I'm fine. I hook far side, and then I slide my other leg in and hook reverse near side. If you're having trouble reversing near side, it's because your hips are trying to face this way. Let your hips rotate towards the same way as your opponent, so when I throw my leg backwards, it's not a problem to hook over top. Now, when I hook over top, in the weird instance that he chooses to continue circling, I'm just going to pull over. But more often than not, when I hook both feet, they stop circling and try to pull away. So what I do is the hand that was blocking, I reach over, I grab this far lat, the hand that was on this arm comes up to the mat far enough away that he can't reach. If I post here, he's gonna grab it, I'm in worse position. I post far. Now I use this foot that's with reversed, I use this lat, I use this post, I pull my hip out, and if you notice I keep my leg curled the entire time I can do it. Not always at a shorter lever to pull out, but I can keep his arm trapped and I can start pushing down on his shoulder. Now, if I can't get this hook, so it's so steep that I really can't get a good bite on it, I immediately shoot this leg out, step where his knee's going to be. You notice he no longer has an option of stepping outside. So when I pull this way, he can step and he can follow. If I pull with this, he can't step, he falls. So that's the goal. Now the second thing I have to worry about is where my hips are. You notice this is his length. This is where his weight is. My weight is slightly off center of his. What I need to do is I need to get my hips lined up with his hips. So I'm actually going to jump over towards his hip. Now if you notice, he's kind of falling already and I haven't actually done anything. I grab this tricep, whatever I need, tricep, bicep. I block the arm, I kick this foot up, and I pick it up. So between the three, they all cover each other's weaknesses. But in the instance that you missed the step over, you missed the step up, and you missed the hip flip, he's gonna continue circling all the way around, and he's gonna be stuck like this. Yes. So first thing I need to do before he gets a chance to step on his hips, I need to cross my knees. Now, how you're gonna do this, lengthwise, depends on where he's at, but the only thing I need to worry about is getting this foot hooked on this side. If I can get this hooked on this side, I can pull it back to one-on-one. If you notice, I'm using these, my feet, as an anchor point. The same way someone holds your feet as you do a sit-up, I'm using his weight the same way. So I'm pushing into him, maybe I'm using underhooks or whatever, but all my power is coming from my feet. My feet are holding onto his hips. So as he tries to fight me and push down and into me, he's actually giving me a stronger base to kick my feet up and hold myself up. So what's gonna end up happening is kind of end up at an equilibrium where he can't push any farther, I can't push any farther. When you get to that point, stop one side completely from reaching outside and start rolling that way. Now, What's gonna happen is if he's really forcing his weight down low, I'm gonna start kicking these legs out as far as I can. You notice his foot is not on the ground. He no longer has an option of posting that leg. You notice I'm just rolling away and he's still falling. Ooh. That's pretty much it.